Hey, y'all didn't have to clap for us coming up like that. We really appreciate that, don't we, Mary? That was very nice. We really did appreciate that. You wouldn't think anybody famous is behind us at all. Hey, it's Joel and Mary from the morning show on My Country 99.3 WCUN. Welcome to the Chattahoochee Mountain Fair.
Yes, we are so glad to be here tonight, and we're even more excited to hear this awesome band behind us. But we do want to encourage you to tune in and listen to us every morning. We're on from 6 to 10. We have everything to get you ready to start your day, to get you ready for work. And of course, we have our topic of the day and the music that made country great,
which would include Grammy nominated Sony recording artist all the way from Chattanooga. Let's give a big Northeast Georgia welcome, a My Country welcome to Confederate Railroad.
The young man's name that was on before us, but I did stand outside and listen, and wherever you are, son, you did a great job. So y'all give him a big hand there. So how about a number one record about a wild woman in Memphis goes like this right here? Yeah. Thank you.
record.
Our folks got to be up front with you here. We was in Memphis, Tennessee last night, had some sound issues. And my voice, I might miss a couple of high notes tonight because we had some monitor issues. But just want to tell you up front now, I ain't going to try to hide them. Here's your top 10 record about a time I fell in love with a northern woman. Went up to Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, and met a little old blonde-headed gal. Brought her home to Tennessee. My family wouldn't have nothing to do with her. So I found out she's a big fan of two things we hold very sacred here in the Southeast. That being Elvis Presley and the Andy Griffith Show. Here's your hit record based on that tumultuous love affair. Up here and work with different artists in the music business. And every show that we do, I like to go back and pay tribute to some of our former employers. First, I'm going to take it back to the 1980s when myself and Mark back here used to work for a great country music singer by the name of Johnny Paycheck. Y'all remember Paycheck? I ain't got it. We worked for old John right after he went back to prison that last time. Suppose it is for Paycheck and anybody else here that ever spent the night in jail. You don't have to raise your hands, ma'am. But if you spent one night in jail, raise both hands. There folks, look around, see who your convicts are here. Off our Cheap Thrills album, put this as a tribute to Paycheck on our album, Cheap Thrills. 11 months and 29 days, boy. Goes back to prison. Mark and I choose to look for work elsewhere. Went to work for a man that just got out of prison. Country music's a lot different 40 years ago. Went to work for a man the name of David Alvin Cole. I got some Cole fans here tonight. We were David's band for several years right after we got the railroad contract. Talked to David just the other day. He turned 83 last Tuesday. Back in my day, when I was running all over the world with David Alvin Cole, I would have bet he wouldn't have made 60. And that tough old buzzard, 83 years old. David ain't in the best of health, but if he ever does get back on the road and do shows, y'all please try to go see him. Now, what I'm leading up to here, back in 1982, I recorded this next song. Then a couple years later, I talked David into recording, but he left out my favorite verse. So we put this on the first Confederate Railroad album one last time. So few of ours need a little time off for bad behavior. But I'm a man gone, every day of dawn, just from working like a regular dog. But you can walk down the water and the lights and the phone turned on. I've been saying yes, sir, all day at work. I've been sleeping yes, ma'am, home. Saving up my cuz, working, keeping up under my throne. I need a little time. And needless to say, after spending much of my adult life running around with those two, I've never claimed to be a saint. But I am a man of faith, and I was very proud to have this our first number one record. It's called Jesus and Mama. Made a wish upon a star that I could have a brand new car. I got tired of wishing, so I stole one. 17 at all. My dreams are big, but my thoughts are small. So many roads, somehow I chose the wrong one. This house Christmas church. Tell you why I wrote this next song. Things first started going good for us years ago. The first thing I did, went out and bought me a nice big fancy house. Nice big fancy neighborhood there in my hometown of Chattanooga, Tennessee. My ex-wife just sold that house a few years ago. But back in happier times, we moved in there. One of the neighbors came up to me one day and he said, you know, when we found out you was moving in the neighborhood, we had a community meeting. Come to find out he's a great concern about the hillbillies moving in. Rather get upset with him, cause a big ruckus, chose to take the high road and do the Christian thing. So I turned the other cheek, went back in the house, and wrote him this song. See, here's one of my former neighbors, like my old buddy Toby Keith for naming his album after this a couple years later. So 10 of mine, white trash with money. their band. The radio plays all the railroad songs. They ran a boom, listen all day long. The Stunner Boys like shirts turned out swell. If the neighbors don't like it, they can all go wrong. Sold a million records and made a little cash. The doctors and the lawyers don't think it's funny that we're living next door like trash and money. Yeah, life's just fine, we made our money. That just ain't white trash with money. Say, sure. What you reckon the neighbors would say if I put us a couple of pink flamingos out there in front of the yard? Aw. Well, you reckon I ought to throw them old tires away or just paint them white and plant flowers in them like I do up there in Blue Ridge? A couple of wealthy ex-wives. Speaking of that ex-wife that sold that house, I still ain't forgive her. Wrote several songs about that old gal over the years. Early in the relationship, wrote some of the sweetest love songs ever put down on paper. Here's one I wrote at the end of the relationship. I began to have a different view of her by this time. Come time to put this on the record, I thought there might be some legal issues, so I got Mo to sing it. Jared Mo to sing a song I wrote about my ex-wife, better known as the plaintiff. Mighty Mo Faxton, the man I am today.